In this video, we're going to talk about carbon filtration with a particular focus on passive and fan-assisted filters. G'day Dale, how are you doing?
I'm doing good.
So just tell me big picture again, what is carbon filtration? How does it work when it comes to odour control?
Okay, carbon filtration is a very common technology used in odour filtration, especially in the wastewater environment. It's an absorptive media that absorbs the contaminated gas when we send the contaminated gas through the vessel.
All right, good. And when you talk about contaminated, you mean smells bad?
Smells bad, yes.
All right, good. Now, there's some differences here. There's something called a passive system and a fan-assisted system. Can you talk about what they are and how they're different?
Okay, so passive systems are usually installed on pump stations where they're there to take care of displaced air from inflow from the sewer mains. Usually just small systems, don't usually go any bigger than say 120 litres per second. That's about the limitations of them. They're common and they're usually on most pump stations just to take care of, like I said, any displaced air that may be sent through.
So we're talking about sewerage for a city or a council in particular?
Yeah, municipal councils. And,
okay, yeah. Good. And then fan-assisted is something else?
Fan-assisted is something else, yeah. That's where we're actually forcibly extracting the air out of a vessel or a wet well and forcing it through the carbon filter.
So we're talking about carbon filtration systems. In particular, the difference between a passive system and a fan-assisted system.
Yes.
And what I was going to ask is, a passive vent is what we're talking about, isn't it?
A passive vent is what we're talking about. A passive vent is not extracting or forcing any air through the filtration system.
Okay.
It's actually just in place, and it just takes the air that is forced through by what is happening in the pump station rather than us actually forcing it through physically.
Okay, good. And we've spoken about using this in sewerage, for example, public storage situations. What are some of the other situations you might use using one over the other?
Passive filtration's pretty much only used in sewerage applications. Very rarely would it be used in an industrial application.
Right.
That would be when we would go to forced extraction.
And what kind of industries are we talking about?
Food manufacturing, grease trap waste, hydrocarbons, tire manufacturing, bitumen, anything that could create a smell that is offensive to the
public. I can only imagine that bitumen manufacturing would have all kinds of chemical odours that would be quite toxic.
Yeah, quite.
So you've got
complex.
To bring them out with a fan and then you deal with them through.
Yes.
Do you use the same kind of carbon every time or is there
a
different?
No, it's very important that we choose the carbon specifically to suit the odour profile, and there are many types of carbons.
Can you give me just a couple of examples?
Yeah, caustic impregnated carbon, vapour carbons, granulated, there's all sorts, there's so many. Like I said, it's very important that we consider what we're dealing with and we suit that carbon to suit the odour profile.
Okay. How does a passive or fan-assisted system remove the odour or at least reduce the odour when it comes to the hydrogen sulphide smells?
The activated carbon actually absorbs the hydrogen sulphide. So until it reaches its capacity, it's like a sponge. It will absorb that H2S into the activated carbon and hold on to it until it's reached its capacity, and then it needs to be changed.
Okay, good. And can I ask roughly how long does it take? Is it like replace it every 24 hours?
No, we aim for 12 months. We like to get 12 months. Sometimes we get longer. Sometimes we get a little bit less. It just depends on the odour concentration and how high the ppm of the H2S is or whatever we may be treating.
And how do you know when the carbon activated carbon has run out?
We do have systems that can give us a signal.
Like a measurement?
We have breakthrough indicators that will change colour when the H2S starts to break through the activated carbon, and then we can get a visual indicator. But most of the time, it's just, it starts
every
to smell
months,
again.
It starts
and
to smell.
They get complaints and then we'll change the carbon. So it's usually the way the councils do it.
All right, no worries. Yeah. So Dale, I want to ask a question that's a little bit different here. The money question. What's the pricing? What's the price point of this sort of system?
Look, when it comes to odour treatment and when we talk about the different types and the different technologies, activated carbon is one of the more economical and simple ways to deal with it. And the lovely thing about it is it just always works. It's a really great solution. The disadvantage of it is that the media does have to be changed, so it does have some maintenance costs.
Some ongoing maintenance. I think you were saying replace filters every 12 months or so.
Yeah, replace filters about every 12 months, yes.
Okay, good. So worth knowing that this is kind of the bargain as it comes to odour control.
As far as implementation, it's a very cost-effective way to deal with an odour.
All right, terrific. Thank you. Okay. Appreciate that. If you'd like to find out more, please visit us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au. That's bulbeckenviro.com.au. Please feel free to reach out, an email, a phone call. We'd be more than happy to help.